How's it going, everyone? So today I finished trading. It's currently 7:51 and I've hit my daily goal of $100. I don't know if you guys can. That's been my daily goal for the past, I want to say, month or so, right? I scaled from $20 a day to $50 a day to $100 a day, and just about now I'm waiting to get over the PDT rule, right? And that's coming soon. As soon as I'm able to do that, I will scale up to 200 daily, and then from 200 go to maybe 300 or 400, just slowly scale every month, you know. But yeah, the beginning of this year has been phenomenal in terms of consistency, and I decided to pick up the camera again to just record little bits and pieces of every trading day and throughout the week. I guess if I do anything fun, spontaneous, or adventurous, I'll take you guys with me. But how's it going, everyone? I'm back for this next following clip, and it's currently 3:25 p.m. I just finished kind of going over my trades from today, or my trade from today, which I only took one. I'm gonna put you guys on a little free game right here. This is essentially the best thing I could have possibly done for my trading journey, right? Which is journaling my trades, journaling, printing out my charts, journaling my trades, so I know what I did wrong and I make sure I don't do it again, or at least be aware of what I'm doing wrong. And if it's habitual, meaning that if I do it consistently, then I come to my realization of what I'm doing wrong sooner, right? And this is pretty much it right here. It's really, really long, and every time I have a new one, I just kind of make a new page for it, right? Oh shit. But I grade myself based on pretty much five criteria: my risk, my selection, my size, my strategy, my breadth, sophistication, and patience. And each of them is 2 points, right? As today, even though I was up 100, my daily goal, I gave a brief explanation of what I feel like I did wrong, which today I kind of sized in way too heavy and resulted me in risking way too much money. So both size and risk got affected in this grading score or whatever. And then here at the bottom, I just put what I can do better tomorrow. And simply put, I summarize everything, size accordingly, stay humble to my system, and read my system every morning. And my system is written down here to my left side. I would show you guys, but it's not. It's my system, what works for me. You know, everyone's system is going to be different. And by system, I mean kind of like criterias that meet my entry, and then criterias that meet my exit, and then so on. It's essentially formulating a game plan, you know, a game plan that I follow consistently. And just reading it every single morning reminds me of what I'm looking for, what not to do. Journal. Apart from that, I print out the chart from the day, right? So this is its future, and this is the correlating, the inverse ETF. And here on the bottom, just simple notes that pretty much I write over here on my journal. And this is just my normal screen, 100 on the day. Not bad, you know. Like I said in this previous clip that you guys saw before this one, I will size up once I get a little bit more cushion, right? Once I get over the PDT rule, which is fairly soon, I want to get a little bit over, so grand over the PDT 26 for me to size up to 200 daily. And then once I start sizing up those numbers, like 200, 300, 400, 500, which is the targets monthly, after I get to the 200 daily, I want to do that consistently for a period of 10 period. If I can do that consistently for 10 trading day periods, meaning if I follow my plan correctly for 10 consecutive trading days, then I can size up right to 300 daily. And then once I can do that for 10 consecutive trading days, and 400 daily, and so on and so forth, you know. I don't want to, but the reason is I know that if I follow my system, I will be profitable, right? Now, the only difference between making 100 and 1,000 daily, as a lot of you traders know, is how many shares you buy, right? And if I'm able to really consistently follow my system, which works for me, then the only barrier for me now is the emotional side of sizing up, right? Because when, of course, you put on more size, you take on more risk, right? And it's just something I want to work towards. I want to make sure I have 10 consecutive good quality trades, meaning that I follow my system. They can be read, but I follow my system to a T for me to size up heavier, right? Meaning I can manage more risk. But yeah.
Where are we going, G?
No, we're finna just go home. We just got back from eating some food. Chipotle, small ass burrito.
What'd you get?
And some, I got, I want Chipotle?
Yeah, yeah, what'd you get?
I just got chicken, white rice, and fucking sauce, some cheese, and some lettuce.
How old are you?
Come on now.
What's your social? What'd you get?
I got a bowl. I got this drink, Quickly, is my favorite, Thai tea with boba, and then I got guac and chips.
What'd I get?
You got another bowl.
Another bowl? With some Jamba Juice.
You weren't even recording us. You were like,
what do you mean? I was recording you, bro. I was recording you guys. No, but yeah, we just came back from getting some food. About to go home and eat it, but I'll pick up the vlog or the video probably tomorrow after I'm done trading.
How's it going, guys? Today it is Tuesday, right? I don't know where exactly this vlog is going to be because it's all over the place, but straight into it. Today, $207 on the day, right? $207 real account. One trade today. One stock, two trades, but one was on my full position. And right now I'm currently just drawing out the journal, not drawing out, but going over my journal and my trade, kind of reviewing my trade, reviewing stocks for tomorrow. You know, the most important thing that I could have done was journal. Journaling really, it gets rid of the things that you're doing wrong and really improves on what you're doing. It essentially makes you an overall rounded trader, right? Because without journaling, without writing down what you're doing wrong, you're not gonna really capitalize on those mistakes unless you're aware of them, right? And most of the times we usually tend to lie to ourselves in terms of what we're doing right and wrong. And in a market like this, like the stock market, there's literally zero room for error, right? We have to follow our procedures, our strategy to the T every single day. Now, I mean, little free game I'll throw at you guys is print out your charts, draw out the lines, you know, trace out the lines, see what you can do better tomorrow, see what you do to good today, and grade yourself. You know, grade yourself like it was a classroom, you know? The way I grade myself is on my journal, I start off by grading myself on risk, stock selection, size, strategy, and then the last part is a combination of three things: breadth, sophistication, and patience, right? Pretty much essentially how patient I was with the quality of the trade, essentially. And each of them are 2 points, so it's a total of 5 sections, 2 points each, 10 points, you know? Some days I'll get 5, some days I'll get 4, and 4 out of 10, and I'll have a green day. Some days I'll have a 10 out of 10, and I'll have a red day. So it doesn't matter if it's green or red in terms of what day, you know, green or red day. What matters is that I follow my strategy to the T, you know? How's it going, everyone? So today I ended the day a little bit over $100, $101 to be exact. So that puts me up $200, $300, $400 up on the week so far, which is very, very good. You know, I've had 3 out of 3 consecutive green days. But yeah, just a little update. Today I am going to the beach. It's nice and sunny out today. So yeah, I'll take you guys with me, record a little bit of that. I know the clips haven't been really organized, but whatever. I've said that multiple times. Yeah, let's go get a workout, and I'll take you guys for this workout and just see how it goes. See you later. So this is my platform right now. Account, everything, as you can see, I can switch everything. It's my real account. Today on the day, 101. There you go, P&L on the day. Yeah, total of 2 day trades. My first day trade was kind of a bad trade. I just got a little bit impulsive and didn't wait for true confirmation. I'm opening the blinds for lighting. But managed to come through, pull through, and ended up green on the day, you know? But yeah, I'll take you guys through my workout now.
Bye. I was distracted and in traffic, I didn't feel it when the earthquake happened, but it really got me thinking. Were you out drinking? Were you in the living room chilling, watching television? It's been a year now, think I figured out how to let you go and let communication die out. I know, you know, we know you weren't down for forever and it's fine. I know, you know, we weren't meant for each other and it's fine. But if the the world was ending, you'd come over, right? You'd come over and you'd stay the night. Would you love me for the hell of it? All our fears would be irrelevant. If the world was ending, you'd come over, right? The sky'd be falling and I'd hold you tight.
How's it going, everyone? So today I got an unfortunate red loss, right? I ended today my 7-day green streak, and as you guys can see, 224 on the day loss. So today, of course, I'm still up on the week, but today was a little loss, right? That I did a couple mistakes that cost me. My max loss should have been $100, right? And just because I did these small losses, these small mistakes, they ended up resulting in a larger gain, right? And one of them, pretty much the main two core ones, was hesitation. I hesitated a lot today, a lot. And part of it was because I wasn't really fully prepared at market open. And then, which brings back to my confidence. My confidence was really not at its fullest because, again, preparation equals confidence. And my second one is I added to my losses, right? I added to a losing position, which is pretty much on the top of my criteria for risk management, right? And I shouldn't have done that. And just doing those two things alone, little simple mistakes, really cost me a lot of money. Sorry, my little brother's downstairs. I'm currently home with at my parents' house. My little brother's screaming downstairs, if you guys hear that in the background. But yeah. Why are you screaming for?
Huh?
Why are you screaming for?
Huh?
Huh? Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm trying to record a video and you're here screaming. Why are you screaming?
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Ready to work out?
Yes, sir.
Give me like... But yeah, anyways, those two simple mistakes, right? Hesitation and adding to my losses that I know I'm aware of, but today just, I was on the wrong side of the market majority of the times, which resulted in me having a larger than expected loss, right? But tomorrow's a new day. Let's see how that goes. My little brother's still screaming in the background, but I'll see you guys in the next clip. Oh, today I'm sure you guys will meet a good friend of mine who also trades. We started this journey roughly at the same time, and if he wants to, he's a little bit more conservative with exposure. But if he allows me to, then I'll show you guys and maybe record a conversation with him and I. We plan on going to get some drinks later on today. But I'll show you guys that, see how that goes, and I'm sure you guys will like him. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next
one. Wait, I say what?
All right, how's it going, everyone? So it's a little late night action, and as I promised, my fellow trading partner, introduce yourself.
My name is Jaime. We started around the same time, like around a year and a half ago, and we've been at it for a while now.
Yep, you heard it, people. Right now what we're doing is actually just going over. I have two monitors. One of them is pretty much the only one I use, and this one, I still need to get another quarter extension to plug it into my, to have dual displays, right? But he's taking over it right now pretty much, and what we're doing is pretty much going over plays for tomorrow. I'm looking at certain areas of I guess you could say critical areas where it's looking like there's going to be a change of direction, and I'll let him briefly explain what he's looking for tomorrow.
Yeah, so the way I do it is I just look for levels from the day before that are significant that I can potentially trade the day after, and that's essentially the basis of my strategy.
So they kind of know my strategy in a nutshell, you know?
Yeah.
What would you say is, like, if you were to describe it in like a couple words, like, what do you focus on?
So it's, I identify significant levels and then I confirm them with the Fibonacci levels.
Interesting.
And then if they're confirmed, I take it in based on volume confirmation thereafter, and then some time in sales in level two as
interesting,
well.
Interesting. Just today I'm kind of getting his whole strategy. I knew the gist of it, but just today he's kind of breaking it down for me, and it's something that I'm actually gonna start using too, because I actually like the whole Fibonacci approach. But just gonna try it out, see how it works, and of course continue trading my own strategy. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next clip, see what we're doing.
Alright, so on the day today, not a huge P&L, but it was $86. Huge loss on my first trade, which was 115, and it put me down instantly at the market open, right? And on the week, up my daily goal of $300 a week. I'm guessing this is gonna be the last clip of this video. Let me know what you guys think. And let me just show you guys my actual real account. And I imported everything on TraderView. TraderView is a free platform where you can import your trades from Thinkorswim, and it just kind of it jots down data for you, right? Instead of you doing it manually, it jots down pretty much everything. Your total gain and loss for the week. Mine was 271 for the week. If I wanted to check the month, right? Since May 1st, we're on May 8th. It's 358. Your biggest loss, biggest gain. It's a pretty cool little feature, you know, that you can use, and it's free. It's free for a certain amount of trades per month. After that, if you want full on access, of course, it's like a monthly subscription. But I really, really like it. I really like using it because whenever I would track data, I would use an Excel sheet and pretty much track whatever this is telling me, you know, for free, and which is pretty cool. The only thing I do now other than that is my journaling, which is crucial. 100% would recommend for every single trader out there starting, and printing out my charts, drawing out the charts and seeing where I could have done better, and of course seeing what I did wrong. Great week today, great end to the week. If you guys like these kind of videos where it's more so not necessarily me showing you guys how to do things, but more so documenting, which is my goal, my objective, to document, leave a comment below, let me know what you guys think. And I just created my an Instagram and a TikTok. I know TikTok, I was surprised by the amount of organic reach that TikTok has. I uploaded videos, they instantly got over 1,000 views, and it's crazy the reach that you can get on a new platform, you know. And so I uploaded a whole bunch of trading videos, just live videos on there. And I also made another Instagram other than my personal one. They're both Traderversity. Trader University. I combined both words. And the objective for these platforms is not so much to teach, it's more so to get with a group of like-minded individuals who trade maybe how I trade. Maybe learn from each other, you know. Maybe if I upload a video of how to use maybe time and sales or level 2, someone can go ahead and comment, this is the approach I take, this is what I do. If I upload a video on levels, right, someone can go in and comment, this is how I approach levels, and just so on, just to learn, basically to learn from each other, you know. I'm not better than you, you're not better than me, we're growing together, and that's the overall main objective with those platforms. Because when I uploaded on TikTok first, I got a whole bunch of hate when I was uploading my P&L, and I wasn't uploading to brag, but I can see why people took it that way. I got comments such as, only 100, you're gonna get taxed on this money. Like, no shit, I get that, I know that, bro. But long story short, it's funny how people can be so negative, you know. But that's beyond the point. I don't care about that. I just really want to grow on those platforms and get a collective group of like-minded individuals, like I said. But I'll leave the name down below, and or the links down below, and then you guys can just go and follow them if you guys do see value in them. But yeah, like always, make sure you guys like, comment, share, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week. Peace.